Time, so no time is left for your other speaker. It's for your information. Sri Elamaram Kareem ji.
Thank you, sir. I am very sorry to say that the speech of Honorable President is missing the real issues of the people and the country. Our country is passing through a serious economic crisis. That serious problems are not mentioned in the speech. This government has failed miserably in protecting and upholding our constitution. This is a government which is using all its might to destroy the principle of secularism and fraternity enshrined in our constitution. Those forces behind this government are working day and night, putting their efforts to destroy the communal harmony in our society and perpetuate violence to make minorities of our country unsafe, to feel unsafe. My dear colleagues in the Treasury bench, your eyes and ears are closed towards the livelihood issues of this country. Your hands are stained with the blood of common men, which you have squeezed to make your corporate masters happy. The term "you people are in power" will be written in the history books as dark age of our democracy. Sir, Honorable President's speech have miserably failed in addressing the shameful situation of our nation, of the present condition of our nation. This government has really worked hard to transform our country literally to a graveyard. This address has failed to mention regarding the worst ever economic slowdown our country is facing now. There is consistent stagnation and decline in national savings rate, domestic capital formation, decline in growth of investment, and decline in growth in various industrial sectors. Widespread unemployment and worsening situation of poverty led to sharp decline in effective demand and contraction of commodity market. This in turn resulted in drastic cut in capacity utilization of industries, close down and shutdown of production, leading to retrenchment, layoff and wage cut, etc., aggravating impoverishment. Further, unemployment rate is at 45 years high. This is the present picture of our country's economy. President's address has failed to mention all this. This government has failed in defending the constitution of our nation. It ignored its duty to protect the basic structure of our constitution. The recent amendments to Citizenship Amendment Act undermines the secular concept of citizenship enshrined in the constitution. It discriminates a section of people in the country. As per our constitution, citizenship should never be on the basis of religion. This government have derailed this principle by passing the Citizenship Amendment Act, and this act is at the latest episode in the series of Destroy India by our rulers. Honorable President in his speech congratulated this government for passing certain legislation within few months, but it was through undermining the process of this parliament, and no parliamentary scrutiny was allowed. And what is the meaning of the parliamentary process, sir? The speech is having a mention over the Supreme Court verdict on Ayodhya. Back in 1992, before the historic monument Babri Masjid got demolished, there were verdict and direction from different courts. This country remembers how these people who are in power now treated those verdicts. They were leading the violence and demolished the Babri Masjid. It is interesting to hear that these people are respecting the judiciary now. The speech also tells that the violence, the name of protest, will weaken the society of the nation. So what the citizens in this country should do, when the violence is perpetuated by the government. We have witnessed the government-sponsored violence in different parts of the country against peaceful protests. The incidents happened in our prestigious educational institutions, and universities clearly proved this. Last day we saw a person firing the students, and the police in the backside are simply watching it, as if they're watching a game. So does not all this weaken our nation? Sir, the speech indirectly mentioned that massive mandate. What about that mandate? After the victory of Lok Sabha, if that position exists now, what happened in Maharashtra? The Chanakyas of the ruling party, day and night working to put the BJP government in Maharashtra. Finally, that Chanakyas are sunk in the Arabian Sea, and the anti-BJP government has came to power in the capital, the financial capital city of India. And what happened in Jharkhand? So the mandate, it is an old story. If you are continuing or arguing about that mandate, is it a license given to you to enact any law as per your whims and fancies, and citizens should obey it? I would like to remind this government that this mandate is not for derailing our constitution. If you enact such legislations which are against the values and principles of our constitution, the people don't expect the people of this country to follow it. Now look at the protests throughout our country, not only in our country, world over, protests are going on against the Citizenship Amendment Act. Yesterday, a group of people assembled in front of the headquarters of UN and protested against the CAA. Is it a proud to this country? Kerala, I am proud to say.
Sri Elamaram Kareem,
yes, I am coming, sir.
Just 1 minute. You have total 14 minutes allotted to your party.
Yes.
And there are two speakers. One is Sri KK Rangesh.
Yes, yes, yes.
So you have already taken 7 minutes. Please,
yes,
keep in,
yes,
mind.
I know, sir. I am proud to say that Kerala has shown the way to the whole nation by passing a resolution in the assembly unanimously. The lonely member of the ruling party, BJP, also supported that resolution. And under the leadership of Chief Minister...
He didn't support the resolution, he opposed that resolution. And he has also given a request to the speaker that unanimously passed has been deleted, should be deleted.
That was not correct. He didn't oppose.
Mr. Rangarajan, you were not supposed to intervene. It's not going on record.
No, unanimously, that is the record in the Kerala Assembly. And a joint agitation was put forward in Kerala and followed by a human chain. Participated 7.5 million people of Kerala. And after that, different assemblies has passed resolutions protesting CAA, and that protest should be considered by the government. The spirit of the people should be definitely considered by the government. Sir, our country, the economic situation I mentioned, in the budget, government has announced all-out privatization of the prestigious public sector. Sir, the country is destroyed. The people of this country, particularly working people and peasantry, are in a miserable condition. In these circumstances, I can't support the thanks motion of presented by the ruling member. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. So for your other speaker, 5 minutes are left. 5 minutes are left. No, you are not supposed. Your name is not there. Please, not going on record. Not going on record. Sri Trichu Siva. Nothing is going on record. Sri Trichu Siva. Nothing is.